Hello, and welcome to this presentation, developed by the Criminal Justice Testing and Evaluation Consortium, also known as CJTEC. CJTEC is a program of the National Institute of Justice. In this presentation, co-authors Rebecca Shute and Tyler Ovington will summarize findings with a focus on physical, cognitive, and chemical DUID screening products. From CJTEC's recent publication, a landscape study on field-portable DUID screening products. The inclusion of a product or company in this report does not represent NIJ's or CJTEC's recommendation, endorsement, or validation of product claim. Please join me in welcoming Rebecca and Tyler.
This CJTEC study summarizes two categories of on or near market products that can help support assessment of impairment in a field setting: physical and cognitive screening products and chemical screening products. DUID is a growing challenge for law enforcement. It's difficult to understand the link between the amount of drugs in an individual's system and their level of impairment, even for a trained officer. Drug recognition experts and advanced roadside impaired driving enforcement officers are trained to assess impairment and its causes, such as drugs. But high training costs make these resources scarce. Agencies may consider DUID screening products to help law enforcement investigate DUID cases more efficiently and effectively. We knew that there was a world of emerging innovations to assist in DUID investigations. We see these crop up in trade magazines or the news. However, at the time, there was no comprehensive guide to segment, compare, and understand value and limitation of these products. This product guide is structured similarly to a consumer report, intended to help decision makers understand what types of products are out there, what role they can play in DUID investigations, and what the realities are for adopting these products.
In this report, we looked at products in two broad categories. First, physical and cognitive impairment screening products, and second, chemical screening products. In the first category, the impairment screening products can help law enforcement assess whether an individual is impaired or lacks the capability to operate a vehicle. So these products might improve delivery of the standardized field sobriety test, help document parts of that test, or even in some cases, help predict whether an individual might be impaired based on data collected during the test. The chemical screening products focus on detecting if drugs are present above a specific cutoff concentration in an individual's system.
Physical and cognitive screening tools capture a driver's inability to perform physical or cognitive tasks. These products can be hardware or software-based. While most on-market tools are software products meant for tablets and phones, some use more sophisticated hardware such as cameras or headsets. The report profiles on and near-market products that measure a variety of factors, including horizontal gaze nystagmus or reaction times. These products can fit into one or more of three buckets: those that are meant to optimize delivery of standardized field sobriety tests, those that focus on documenting images, audio, or other data that can be used later in an investigation, and those that measure physiological data and other factors to assess whether an individual is impaired. While on-market products represent a mix of these, many concepts in research and development lean towards those that help make data-driven conclusions of impairment. Chemical screening products detect the presence of a particular drug in an individual system. CJTEC profiled products that indicate presence of drugs in three matrices. Most on-market screening products use oral fluid and consist of a disposable test cassette that operates via lateral flow immunoassay technology. These cassettes may be interpreted manually or read by a sensor. The study profiles products with an associated portable reader, which may reduce the impact of human error. A few products on the market can detect the presence of drugs through sweat samples, which are taken from the forehead or hands. Some developers are working on detection of drugs in sweat from fingerprints. Companies are working to develop products that measure drug metabolites in an individual's exhaled breath, with a focus on metabolites indicative of marijuana use. However, no breath-based products have been launched yet. Both product categories can help support an officer's opinion that an individual may be impaired. The report identifies these key benefits and leverages insights from real end users. Detective Jennings and the Austin Police Department have recognized this benefit through its implementation of the DAX Recorder, a roadside portable evidentiary recording device for alcohol and drug impairment investigations. This device, among other products, can help document evidence of horizontal gaze nystagmus.
But the one thing that we have not been able to really capture before now was the eyes. And when we talk about what your eyes are doing under certain drug categories, there are a lot of the same things we would see from alcohol, which is horizontal gaze nystagmus, vertical gaze nystagmus, those kind of things. But there's also some other things that you can't see and that we don't normally, most officers aren't trained to see, and that's pupillary reaction. What are your pupils doing in different lighting conditions? Are they slow to respond? Are they not responsive? Those kind of things. Our value in what we are trying to do is be able to record that and show a juror what it is that we're seeing. So typically back in the day, if I had a DWI trial and we were trying to explain horizontal gaze nystagmus, we had demonstration videos. We would have some videos that were done in the lab, or we had some videos that were done by some sort of research organization. And we could show that as a demonstrative, but it wasn't that defendant and it wasn't that client. And so that's where a lot of times the courtroom challenges came up, and we would get that from the attorneys. Well, this wasn't my client. This wasn't the defendant in this case. This is just a demonstrative video, right? So we get a lot of that. So what we were really trying to do is find a way to show this actual defendant in a situation where we were able to record their eyes. The good thing about it too is we can pick up their speech from the DAX camera. So when we're holding the camera up, they're recording and they're talking. If their speech is slurred or these other things that we talk about, we can pick that up. The camera gets that.
We can also see the impact of physical and cognitive as well as chemical screening technologies on improving training for law enforcement. Ultimately, well-trained officers are the best assessors of impairment, but these technologies can help more officers understand how to recognize and test for the signs of impairment. Before purchasing these technologies, agencies should consider the realities of adopting these products. Tyler notes some of these limitations.
One of the key realities to keep in mind for these products is that they can only augment, not replace, existing DOID investigation practices. So their value has to be considered in that context. For example, a chemical screening product is limited to performing a presumptive screening. So these products don't provide evidentiary testing, nor do they provide evidence of direct impairment. For physical and cognitive impairment screening products, they may help perform or document a standardized field sobriety test, but they don't replace a standardized field sobriety test. So that skill is still needed by the officer performing the test. And then today, there are still relatively limited number of products that can fill this role for an agency. So you have a limited number of options in procurement, and the cost can be prohibitive, with some units costing over $5,000 per unit. So it can be difficult to adopt one, much less rolled out across the agency. And these different products have technical limitations that must be kept in mind. They don't all try to do the same thing. Some of these products will simply make an observation and help you record that observation for later consideration. And some products try to make data-driven conclusions in the field to assist officers' decision-making. What we've heard so far is that the legal complexity of kind of integrating these different types of products really varies. So it's important to consider, is the product that you're considering only going to capture evidence? Is it going to try to make conclusions in the field? And if it is trying to do the latter, what does the courtroom process think of that? Can it be a benefit to the agency's case? Will it be a detractor, or just make things more complicated in already complicated DOID cases?
In the report, you'll find an adoption guide for both categories of screening tools, which includes three types of considerations. First, an overview of technical limitations. For example, market entry of these products does not indicate that these product claims have been validated, or that agencies are using the product. The report helps manage expectations for abilities of chemical and physical and cognitive screening products. Second, the report covers practical considerations of these innovations, product features or methods of use that make field use easier and safer for law enforcement. Finally, the report considers legal challenges that may impact the value of implementing these technologies. Field portable DUID screening products, when implemented appropriately, may help improve DUID investigations and reduce their burden on law enforcement resources. Please consider how you may support your agencies. Keep them informed of promising new technologies. Understand how these products may fit into your agency workflow. And finally, encourage agency participation in product pilots and baseline data studies. CJTEC is actively exploring many facets of DUID technologies. Check out our follow-on report on technologies to enhance observation, documentation, and training related to DUID.
The NIJ CJTEC monitors trends and developments related to technologies, products, and practices in the areas of criminal justice. This publication was made possible by funding from the National Institute of Justice, Office of Justice Programs, U.S. Department of Justice. For more resources, please check out cjtech.org.